a brief description about what is a class, objects and method in Java. So the introduction part of it. We'll teach you what is a class, basic representation of a class, what is an object, how it is created in a class, that is how an object is created in a class, method and a program demonstrating the above concepts. First we'll see what is a class. A class is a collection of attributes or data members, member function or operations. So what is an attribute? Consider an example class name student, and the attributes of student are student ID, student roll number or student register number, and some of the details of the student. All these are known as the attributes of the class, and member function will be teaching you in the upcoming slides. So the basic definition of the class is that it is a template or a blueprint from which objects are created. So the syntax for the class is that class followed by the class name, and inside that we have data member and methods. So the simple example or simple structure of a class looks is that class followed by the class name. Class name is student, and inside that we have public static void main string args. This is the main method. It must be declared inside all the classes. Next is objects. Objects are instance of class. As discussed in the previous slide, a class provides the blueprint for the object. So basically, object is created from a class. And to create an object, we use a keyword called new. And the syntax for the class, for the object, is that class name followed by the object name equal to new and the class name again. So the example for it, student. Student is the class name, and s is the object name, is equal to new, that is the keyword, and then the class name again, that is student. Next one is method. A method is a program module that contains a series of statements that carries out a task. As seen in the previous slide, a class is a collection of attributes and methods. So to call a method, we create an object to invoke it. So the syntax for the method is that access specifier followed by the return type and then the function name. So the example of how the syntax works is that public is the modifier, int is the return type, add is the name of the method, and int a comma int b is the list of parameters.
Let's see a simple program describing the concept classes, objects and methods. Let me create a file, notepad. All the Java programs should be saved with an extension .java. Let me create a class student. It should contain the main method public static void main string args. Now let me create the attributes for a student. The attributes of the student may be the student's name, register number, and the course which he has opted. The name is of type string of name. I'm declaring it as Maria. The course will be string of type string, course CSE, and the register number is of type integer, int of 045. Let me declare a method public void of display. This is the method in which I'm going to print my student details using system.out.println. Name of class. Similarly, for the other attributes, ln of force plus then the register number and in the main method, I will declare my object for the class. Class is student. This is my class name followed by the object is equal to the new keyword and then my class name. And using the object, I'm going to call my function s.display. Display of. This is my program. Class student is my class. The attributes of the student are name, course, and register number. My method is public void display. I'm going to print the attributes name, course, and register number. And my public static void main is my main method in which I'm creating object for my class and invoking my function method. Now I'm going to compile my program using Java C file name dot Java. Let me run the program Java and my class name. Thus my output is obtained. Name, course, and the register number is printed. Let us see what is. We have another topic called as method overloading. Let us see what is method overloading.
So method overloading is that when a class has two or more methods of the same name but different parameters. It is known as method overloading. So method overloading is also known as static polymorphism. Static polymorphism is known as compiler time binding or early binding. So overloading methods makes program readable. The augmented list, that is, we have different parameters for that. So it differs with number of parameters, data type of the parameter, sequence of data type of parameters. So a small example of is that public int add is add int a comma int b and the body of it, and public int add int a comma int b int c and the body of it.
Let's see a sample program for method overloading. We create a notepad called my function is add.java. Let me create a class called add. Use my main method. Okay. Let me create my attributes. Int A, it's going to be 10. Int B. Int A is 10, B is 20, C is 30. Let me create a dummy variable D which I'm going to store my values. Here I'm going to declare two functions which differs in the number of arguments, void of add int A comma int B. Now, using D, I'm going to add A,